Welcome to your sanitation hub. So today we are going to start with a new chapter, which is NEET from class 7 CBC board from science. So this is your master teacher Shubhra Bharat. So let's start with the chapter. So if you have ever downloaded a Telegram app from Play Store or iOS, then join our Telegram channel. All kinds of PDFs, notes, workbooks, tests, etc. will be uploaded in this channel itself. And the link of our Telegram channel is being given in the description box below. So join the channel soon as possible. So let's start with the chapter, which is heat. So what is heat? So the temperature, the kind of atmosphere we live in. So, in that atmosphere itself, we sometimes face too cold in winter season, mostly that is called as winter season. Now, in that atmosphere itself, we face too hot, and that atmosphere we called as heat. Now, like that atmosphere itself, the ice particles, the water also used to face. Now, each and every thing, whether it is living nor it is non-living, but then each and everything on this biosphere used to experience the kind of temperature which has been present in this atmosphere. So this they sometimes react with the changes in atmosphere, or the substance sometimes doesn't react with the changes in atmosphere. So let's discuss what it defines. With the increase in temperature of a body, the vibrations of the molecules or atoms increase. So the increasing temperature of a body, the vibrations of the molecules or atoms also increases. So these vibrations are then transferred from one part of the body to another. The measure of the energy with which the molecules vibrate in a system is termed as heat stored in that object. Now, the measure of the energy with which the molecules used to vibrate in a system is termed as the heat stored in that object. Now then, as per the definition of the heat, it is defined as a flow of energy from a warm to a cooler object. As per the definition of the heat, it is being defined as a flow of energy from the warm to the cooler object. The direction of the flow of the heat energy takes from the substance to a higher temperature to the substance of a lower temperature. So the heat basically conducts and basically moves or flows to that object where the substance is having or experiencing with a lower temperature. Now this is the molecules. This is because the molecules are vibrating faster and they transfer their energy to the molecules vibrating slower. Now basically the molecules which is being vibrating faster, then tries so that each and every molecule or atoms which is present near them, they also try to experience that they are being experiencing with. So they used to transfer or flow transfer the molecules vibrating slower, and then the vibrational energy is also termed as its heat content, and the heat content is the body makes it hot or cold, and greater the heat content, hotter will be the body. So the heat content in the body makes it hot or cold. So greater the heat content will be, the hotter will be the body. So you can see that the ice, when it is being heated with, it is being melted to water, and then this is the default formation of the ice. So hope you have understood about the heat, and we have also discussed about it in a practical example as per chemistry. So we have understood about it. So let's move to the next slide. So this is basically the difference between the hot and cold. Now the objects with high heat content are defined as the hot. Hotness or coolness of an object is a relative term. It's always measured with respect to the reference to the object. Now, objects with lower heat content are defined as the cold objects. Hotness or coolness of an object is also a relative term and is being always measured with respect to that reference object. Now, basically, we have discussed like this, because hot is nothing but then the object which is being experiencing with the temperature which is higher than a, what we say, a level or a means a defined temperature that we've been given with, that the temperature has been crossed. So that temperature will be calling as the hot, and then if the temperature has not been crossed, and in that case the temperature has gone so lower, so that case we will be called calling as the cold. And then examples of the hot objects like sun, fire, hot pans here from the air dryer, lava from the volcanic eruptions, these all are the hot substances. And the cold substances are the cold objects like the ice here from an air conditioner, cold drinks, metal vessels kept in open on the cold winter days. So these all are the examples of the different, there means apps for the examples of the hot and cold, and we have discussed about the difference between the hot and cold, what we have understood about the difference, and also taken the snapshot of this slide as well. So let's move to the next slide. So now we need to know about the measuring of the temperature. So about the measuring of the temperature, we'll be discussing temperature within slides itself, but then measuring of the temperature around us, we will be able to, when devices used for temperature measurement are different, thermometers, thermocouples or the digital thermometers. The thermometers contain a mercury or any other fluid, then temperature is directly proportional to an expansion of the mercury. As soon as the temperature increases, it causes fluid to expand, and hence the temperature can be measured by measuring the volume of the fluid. Now devices used for temperature such as thermometers, thermocouples or the digital thermometers. Thermometers contain an element which is known as the mercury, or it can be any other fluid. The temperature is directly proportional to an expansion of mercury. As soon as the temperature increases, it causes fluid to expand. Hence, the temperature can be measured by measuring the volume of fluid. There are many temperature measurement devices available, such as thermocouples, resistive temperature devices, RTDS, thermistors, etc. Heat can be directly related to temperature. If the temperature of the object is high, it has more energy, and if the temperature is low, then it has less energy. So basically, there are many temperature measurements devices such as thermocouples, resistive temperature devices, RTDS, thermistors, etc. And then heat can directly be related to the temperature. If the temperature of the object is high, it has more energy, and if the temperature is low, then it has less energy as well. So this is the whole concept of the measuring temperature. Hope you have understood about the measuring temperature. We will be discussing the temperature with temperature in the following next slide. So hope you have taken the snapshot of it as well. So let's move to the next slide. So this is what is temperature. We have discussed about the measuring of the temperature at first, but then there was a replacement, means there was a placement of slides, there was a mistake as per the technical team, but then before that, temperature. So let's discuss about the temperature. That was simply a problem for the technical team, but then what can we do about the technical purposes? We cannot do about it anything. But then temperature. So temperature is a measure of the hotness or the coldness expressed in terms of any several arbitrary scales and indicating the direction in which the heat energy will spontaneously flow, that is, from a hotter body to a colder body. So temperature measure of the hotness or coldness expressed in terms of any of the several arbitrary scales and indicating that the direction in which the heat energy will spontaneously flow, that is, from the hotter body to a colder body, one at a lower temperature. So the temperature is not equivalent to the of the energy of the thermodynamic system. Example, a boiling match is at a much higher temperature than a iceberg, but the total heat energy contained in an iceberg is much greater than the energy contained in a match. So what we have discussed is an example that this is a thermodynamic case, and about thermodynamics you will be learning in the class higher classes, But then before that, if we take a basic concept about it, so burning match is at a how much high temperature than an iceberg. But then can a burning match can dissolve or can melt a large iceberg? You may know what is iceberg. It is found in the Greenland. It is found in North Pole, South Pole. In those places, they have been found with icebergs. Large amount of ice is being gathered together and forms a iceberg. But then can a burning match can melt an iceberg? Never. So the total amount of energy which is being present in iceberg is much more than the total amount of the energy which is being present in a match form, that match. So we have understood about the temperature and about we have discussed within through its example, and we have also discussed by defining it about the measurement of the hotness or coldness expression. So hope you have understood about the temperature. So let's move to the next slide. So this is what thermometer is. So thermometer, by thermometer only we will be able to measure the temperature, whether it's our outer temperature or whether it's our inner temperature. So let's discuss about it, about the thermometer. So thermometer, instrument for measuring the temperature of a system. Temperature measurement is important to a wide range of activities, including manufacturing, scientific research, and medical practice. So, temperature instrument is used to measure the temperature of a system. But then, temperature measurement is important to a wide range of activities, that is, including with manufacturing, scientific research, and medical practice. The invention of a thermometer was done, generally credited to an Italian mathematician, famously as well as physicist. He was famously known as Galileo Galilei. In his instrument built about 1592, and the changing temperature of an inverted glass vessel produced an expansion for the contraction of the air with the net, which in turn changed the level of the liquid into which the vessel's long open mouth neck was partially filled, and this general principle was perfected in succeeding years by experimenting with the liquids such as mercury and by providing a scale measuring to the expansion and contraction brought about in such liquids by rising and falling temperatures. So what it is telling that this instrument was built in 1592, and then it was being invented by Galileo Galilei, a famous Italian mathematician as well as physicist, and then the changing temperature of an inverted glass vessel. So now we are being discussing about the concept of thermometer in practical. So which in turn change the level of the liquid. So change the level of the liquid, and then because the inverted glass vessel produced an expansion or contraction of the air within it, and which in turn change the level of the liquid, which in kind of expansion or contraction, it changed the level of the liquid with which the vessel's long open mouth neck was partially being filled, and this general principle was perfected in succeeding years by experimenting with liquids such as mercury and by providing a scale, a kind of scale to measure the expansion and contraction brought about in such liquids by rising, means the rising of temperature as well as the decreasing of the temperature as well, which is then found in the thermometer itself. So this is the total concept of the thermometer. Hope you have understood about it. And this is a image of the digital thermometer that we use today. And this is the earlier thermometer that we also use today, but then the manufacturing of these thermometers has totally been stopped. So this is the whole concept of thermometer. We have discussed in detail and in depth. Hope you have understood about it. So let's move to the next slide. So how to read a thermometer? Now the usage of the thermometer we have understood while we were being engaged with the slide called the measuring the temperature. But then how to read a thermometer? Now wash the thermometer properly with the antiseptic lotion, means antiseptic solution, and then hold it definitely and give a few jerks with which will bring the level of the mercury down below 35 degrees Celsius, because there is very much need for making the temperature which is visible in the thermometer to be getting decreased below 35 degrees Celsius. I place the bulb of thermometer under the tongue. Whether we can freeze in the under the tongue as well as in the underarm as well, but then wait for 1 minute, take the thermometer out and note the reading, keeping the level of mercury along to the line of sight. Now we need to see after 1 minute, and then we need to take out the thermometer that we have kept, and then we need to look at the mercury, the level of the mercury along the line of the sight. And this reading gives the exact body temperature. And this reading of a temperature gives the exact body temperature in which a person, whether he is suffering from cold and cough, whether the normal temperature we used to test for experiment, as well as when we are sick, we used to see the temperature of a person's body. And it is necessary to state the temperature which is usually denoted by degree Celsius. And then it should be handled with the care, as on heating against some hard object it can break. Now basically is because these are very much light materials and these are very kind of sophisticated goods. So we need to take care, better care of itself, and because any kind of hard object gets struck with it, then it can simply break down into pieces. And we know that when the mercury breaks down, as it is so, as it is an exception of the metals, as an exception of metals for which it gets melted in the room temperature itself, and then its state means the state and the condition at which the mercury wasn't stuck with the organ with the thermometer, it gets changed to various shapes and gets just melts in the room temperature itself. So this is how to read a thermometer. This is the total concept of it. Hope you have understood about it. So let's move to the next slide. So this is the choice of thermometric liquid. Now we need to make a choice of it. Sometimes water means they cannot work. So not like water, there are some other liquids which may not work, and for which we need to have a choice of a thermometric liquid. Whether mercury or alcohol is used as a thermometer depends on the range over which the temperature is to be measured. So the mercury or the alcohol is used in a thermometer which is depending on the range over which the temperature is to be measured. And then mercury freezes at 39 degrees Celsius and then boils at 357 degrees Celsius, while alcohol freezes at 11S and degrees Celsius, and it is therefore essential to use alcohol thermometers in places such as northern Canada and Russia, where winter temperatures of minus 40 degrees Celsius are not uncommon. So in places like northern Canada and Russia, in Russia we know about the Siberia, they are too much cold centers, and for which the temperatures run below minus 40 degrees Celsius sometimes when it is a cold season. So for which we can use a thermometric liquid while the alcohol freezes at this temperature at 100S and 111S, and for which that's why we can use alcohol in these cases. Alcohol also possesses the adventure. It's about the advantage of having an expansive of about 6 times that of mercury. So alcohol used to possess that advantage of having an expansive of about 6 times that of mercury. So alcohol is better. And then apart from these advantages, mercury is to be preferred to alcohol as a thermometric liquid. So mercury is basically being preferred to alcohol for the thermometric liquid for the following reasons. It does not wet glass, and then alcohol tends to clang with the wall of the tube, and this leads to low readings when the thread is falling. It does not like alcohol vaporize and distill onto the upper part of the board, and it is opaque and easily seen, whereas alcohol has to be colored, and it is a better conductor of the heat than alcohol, and therefore responds to more rapidly the changes of temperature. So overall, after defining or discussion of this thermometric liquid, we have understood that alcohol is not better than mercury. Mercury is the best one of the choice of thermometric liquid, and that's why there are many advantages that we get from, apart from these advantages, mercury is to be preferred to alcohol. But then alcohol means the advantage we cannot get much from alcohol, but then in that case we get much more advantage from mercury. So we use mercury as the only thermometric liquid, as a choice of thermometric liquid. So hope you have understood about the choice of thermometric liquid as well. So hit the like button if you have understood till now, and the like button below the video, and press the subscribe button if you have understood till now what we have discussed, because we take a lot of efforts to build such wonderful videos and such wonderful conceptual videos for people. So like the video and subscribe to the channel and increase the family. So this is the choice of thermometric liquid. Hope you have understood about the choice of thermometric liquid as well. So let's move to the next slide. This is the clinical thermometer that we use for the clinics, and this is basically used for measuring the human temperature. The normal default temperature of the human beings is 37 degrees Celsius, and the temperature which may rise to 108 or more than that when the person is sick. So let's read what it defines. Clinical thermometers are meant for clinical purposes. We have discussed now only. It is developed for measuring the human body temperature, and it is a long narrow glass tube with a bulb containing mercury at the end. So this is the bulb containing mercury, and this is a long glass tube. Not a glass tube, this is a basically a digital thermometer, because nowadays we mostly use digital thermometer because seeing the side of vision for the normal thermometers, earlier thermometers was become much more difficult for doing other temperatures. So digital thermometer has been become the usage for nowadays. And then the normal human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, which can fluctuate between the ranges 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. Hence, the clinical thermometers, the range 35 to 42 degrees Celsius, and the level of the mercury tells our body temperature in degrees Celsius. Since mercury is a toxic element, but these thermometers have been replaced by digital thermometers nowadays. So, this is the digital thermometer. So, hope you have understood our clinical thermometer as well. So, let's move to the next slide and discuss about the laboratory thermometer. So this is about the laboratory thermometer. So since clinical thermometer can't be used to measure the temperature other than the human body, we need a special type of thermometer for other purposes. And the laboratory thermometer, which is colloquially known as the lab thermometer. So the laboratory thermometer are basically the lab thermometers which they are being used in labs for the measuring of the temperature. And then the human body, and then it ranges from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. And we can see that the clinical thermometer used to start from 35 to 42 degrees Celsius. But then this thermometer basically starts from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius, and then laboratory thermometers are designed for lab purposes such as checking boiling point, freezing point. You can also use a laboratory thermometer for checking the temperature of a solvent, but not a clinical one. So you cannot do with a clinical one. Weather reporters also use maximum minimum thermometers for measuring the maximum minimum temperatures of a particular place. So basically, laboratory thermometers is very much used in the labs for checking the boiling point, freezing point, and the temperature of the other substances, and the temperature of it is minus 10, from starting from minus 10 to 100 degrees Celsius, 110 degrees Celsius, and then the thermometer. And then clinical thermometers cannot be used in the laboratory cases. So hope you understood the laboratory thermometer as well. This is the whole concept of laboratory thermometer. And what we have discussed about is the temperature, about this ranging of temperature, about we have compared it with the clinical thermometer as well, and then what the usage of laboratory thermometer, or usage of the thermometers in the labs. So we have understood about it. Okay, I have taken a snapshot of it as well. So let's move to the next slide. So this is basically the transfer of heat. So any matter which is made of atoms and molecules has the ability to transfer of heat. The transfer of heat, we have discussed earlier itself, that the atoms and molecules has the ability to transfer the heat. So the heat that is they have been observed used to transfer that heat to other atoms and the molecules that are present nearby. And the atoms are in different types of motion at any time. The motion of the molecules and atoms are responsible for the heat or the thermal energy, and every matter has this thermal energy. Now the motion of the atoms and molecules is responsible for the heat or thermal energy. As the thermal and the heat and thermal energy increases, the motion among them increases. And as the heat and thermal energy decreases, the motion of them slowly decreases. So the more the motion of the molecules will be, the more heat energy. However, the talking about the heat transfer is nothing but the process of the transfer of the heat from the high temperature body to the low temperature one. So this is what transfer of energy we have discussed. This is very easy concepts. only in seconds we are taking to continuing and processing each slides. So these are very easy concepts from the chapter, and basically what we have discussed in transfer of heat is that how the temper, how the motion of the atoms, why is the motion of the atoms and molecules occurs, and then about the responsible for the heat or the thermal and everything about the more the heat increases, what happens to the atoms and molecules, and more the heat decreases, what happens, and then with the motion, why the motion occurs in the atoms and molecules. So all these we have discussed in the transfer of heat. So hope you understood transfer of heat as well. So let's move to the next slide. So let's discuss about the conductors and insulators towards heat. So conductor, conduction in the transfer of the thermal energy between the particles of the matter that are touching, and thermal conduction occurs when the particles of the warmer matter bump into the particles of the cooler matter and transfer some of their thermal energy to the cooler particles, and conduction is usually faster in certain solids and liquids than in gases, and materials that are good conductors of the thermal energy are called the thermal conductors. So the conductors are basically conduction occurs because of the heat that has been absorbed by the atoms and molecules used to transfer the heat, and for which this transfer of the heat occurs due to the conductors itself, because without the conductors the transfer of heat never occurs. So for which these are the good conductors of the thermal energy, and that's why they are also called the thermal conductors as well. Now then, thermal non-conduction also occurs when particles of the warmer matter bump into the particles of the cooler matter and transfer some of their thermal energy and the cooler particles. Now one way to retain our own thermal energy in a cold day is to wear a cloth. This is a practical example. That is because the air, like other gases, is a poor conductor of the thermal energy, and the particles of the gases are relatively far apart so that they don't bump each other or to other things as often as the more closely spaced particles of the liquids or the solids, and therefore the particles of the gases have fewer opportunities to transfer the thermal energy as well, and materials are poor thermal conductors are called thermal insulators. So basically the air is a very poor conductor, and they basically do not conduct electricity. They do not conduct heat, but then they when we wear, this is a practical example we have taken, that when we wear the clothes or the clothes that wrap up in a cool day, so to retain your own thermal energy we need to do that as an experiment. Like that's because, like other gases, in a poor conductor of the thermal energy, the particles of the gases are relatively far apart, and so that they don't bump into each other or into the things as often. Particles of the gases have fewer opportunities, so this helps to transfer of the thermal energy. So examples like air, wood, plastic, glass, and glass, etc. This is the whole concept of the conductors and insulators. We have understood about, we have discussed about thermal conductors as well as thermal insulators. We have taken a practical example from thermal insulators so we can understand that there are insulators towards heat. So we have understood about the thermal conductors and insulators towards heat. So let's move to the next slide. This is what conduction, and conduction is the process by which heat energy is being transmitted from collisions between the neighboring atoms or molecules. So basically this is a process by which the transmission occurs from collisions between the neighboring nearby atoms and molecules, and then adduction also occurs more readily in solids and liquids where the particles are closer together than in gases where particles are further apart. So conduction occurs more readily in solids and liquids, and the particles are very much closer together than in gases where particles are farther spaced apart, and then the rate of the energy transfer by the conduction is higher when there is a large temperature difference between substances that are in contact. The rate of the energy transfer that occurs by conduction is very much higher when there is a large temperature difference between the substances that are in contact with. So this is the image of the conduction that is occurring. So this is what the conduction, the rate of energy that is being transferred by conduction is higher than there is a large temperature. So hope you have understood about conduction as well. These are very easy concepts, and within seconds we are covering so easy concepts. This chapter is very easy for you people to understand and just like anything. And we have shown in detail about how the conduction is occurring. Just we have placed a food inside it. We have placed over it the vessel, the utensil over the bottle. Now this food is getting baked, and then the heat has been provided over the handle as well. So for as the conduction occurs, that's why in the utensils, most of the frying pans, we used to use plastic handles, for which we can help, we can handle with it, because if that is with the same element that has been prepared with the frying pan as well as the handle as well, then we were unable to hold it because both has gone for the conduction cases. So that's why it has been coated with plastic handle, and then this is being occurring, and the heat energy has been generated till before the plastic handle, and the heat energy is being going up, and the heat, the atoms are being getting heated in the utensils, for which the total utensil is getting heated. So we have discussed in detail about the taking the niche as an example of it. So we have understood about the conduction. Let's move to the next slide. We have been taking the snapshot of this slide as well. So let's move to the next slide. So this is what convection. Let's discuss this with the help of the image itself, the discussion, and the just to make it as a more practical, we will be much more, we will be able to understand more clearly. So what is happening in this image? Like in this image, we can see that the heat is being going on, and there is a vessel which is full of water, and the temperature is being going up down. So the upper layer, there are two parts of the water. Basically the water is being in a vessel in a completely is being filled within the vessel, but then the lower part of the water is getting heated, and that's the heated, the lower part of the water is also making the upper part of the water as well as it is being getting heated, and this the temperature is going like a cycle. And then the warmer molecules are covering the place where there are cooler molecules, and this is making what the convection. So convection is a process of the heat transfer by bulk movement of molecules within fluids such as gases and liquids. So this is what convection, and then the initial heat transfer between the liquid object and fluid takes place for the conduction, but the bulk heat transfer happens due to the motion of the fluid. And then the convection is the process of heat transfer into fluids by the actual motion of the matter, and it happens in the liquids and gases, and it may be natural or forced. It involves a bulk transfer of the portions of the liquid. So this is what convection is. We have discussed in detail as per the image and helped you to make understand about these concepts. These are very much important concepts from the exam point of view. Hope you have understood about the conduction as well. And as like the slide of the conduction, hope you have taken the snapshot of this slide as well. So let's move to the next slide. So this is the last part of the chapter, which is a radiation. Let's discuss about the radiation. The heat given off from the sun cannot reach us by the process of conduction or convection, because both the processes require a media output transfer of the heat. But due to the absence of a medium such as air in maximum layers of the space between the earth and the sun, this process cannot transfer the heat to the earth. So conduction and convection occurs through the medium, but then there is no medium between the sun and earth. So how the heat gets transferred, or rather how the heat gets radiated towards the earth? This is because of the process called radiation. So radiation can be described by the energy of the particles from the source that travels to the space or other mediums like heat, microwaves, and then wireless communications are all forms of radiations, and this includes the particle radiation, gravitational radiation, acoustic radiation, electromagnetic radiation. So, such as alpha radiation, beta radiation, and neutron radiation, these are very complicated conceptions that you will be getting in the higher classes. But then, just for examples, just for making just a little bit, we are not discussing in detail about the particle radiation, gravitational radiation, as well as acoustic and electromagnetic, but then just a tiny examples we are giving. gravitational radiation, such as the radiation takes place, form the gravitational waves or the ripples, and then acoustic radiation, ultrasound, and sound and seismic waves, and then electromagnetic, such as radio waves, visible light, X-rays, and gamma radiations. So these are all radiations, and radiations doesn't need any kind of medium. It used to move in open, and it moves through, basically it moves to vacuum where there is no medium to travel. They used to move through space or other medium. So this is what radiation is. We have discussed about it, and this is the image which is showing that the earth is being radiated with the sun, and some of the energy, which is the solar energy, also gets radiated out from the reflected out from the earth's atmosphere as well. So this is what radiation. Hope you have understood of the radiation. Like the other two, the conduction and convection, hope you have taken a snapshot of this radiation as well. So let's move to the next slide. So here this video ends. Thank you for watching the video. Hope all your concepts are crystal clear from this chapter. If you have any doubt after reading the chapter of from NCERT, as well as after watching this video, mention in the comment section below. So here is a error which is being shown, and then it's a printing error, but I don't know about the technical team standing kind of error, but then it's not a problem. But then it's a problem that has occurred. So let's it's a downs has been done, so it's a error that has been done. Sorry for the error. So the like the video, we take a lot of efforts for this, such wonderful videos for people, and then subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get regular updates, and share the video as much as you can. We take a lot of efforts simply to create such wonderful videos for people, to make your concepts too much clear and to be crystal clear like crystals, so that you get the flying colors to come out from exams. Hope all your concepts are very much clear, and stay tuned for the upcoming chapter videos which will be coming from this channel itself. So hit the bell icon so that your the notifications from this channel goes to you as the first one. So keep practicing, keep culturing with the chapters and the science, and bye.